And I don't see Dory. She is my person usually to ask for a stretch. But seems like this is a sign, Gustavo. I'm sorry. You can all place it down. We'll try to do it towards the end. I believe in your dream, so we'll try again. And, you know, I really like statistics, and one of those is that hip has been around now for 18 years. All 18 years. The work and the results that the revision obtains have been featured locally, at the state level, nationally, and even internationally. None of these accomplishments will be possible without the foundation on which hip was built on. Collaboration over competition. Now repeat that again, collaboration over competition. This year's Community Impact Award honors the Pajaro Valley Healthcare District Project and its leaders. This year's Community Impact Awardees embody HIP's values of respect, equity, and fairness for all. The leaders that will join us on the stage are part of a team that led the largest community fundraising campaign in the history of Santa Cruz County. I'm making a good pause there. I want you to hear that applause and feel it, please. Their efforts led to the successful acquisition of Watsonville Community Hospital. I can make it. I'm sure that the positive impact of a publicly owned hospital will be felt by our community members for decades to come, and even one day our grandkids. Please join me in welcoming to the stage Dominique Dursa, District Director at Assemblymember Rivas' office, and Jonathan Eckleman, District Representative at Senator Slade's office, who will provide an award resolution to the Pajaro Valley Healthcare District Project's representatives joining us here today. Dory and Carlos, can you also please join us?
Thank you, and I'll be brief because you know this is about all of us, right? Really, we needed two things to happen for this acquisition to be possible, right? We needed strong leadership in Sacramento, and we're so lucky around here to have Assemblymember Rivas and Senator Laird spearheading SB 418 that created the Pajaro Valley Healthcare District in record time, and to get $25 million from the state budget to help acquire the hospital. But that wouldn't have mattered if we didn't have the strong community outreach and just everyone coming together, everyone in this room and everyone from business leaders to community organizations to local governments and everything just coming together perfectly. And you know, it's just so amazing and inspiring to see what we were able to do when everyone comes together. And the work's not done, right? Now we have to keep the hospital in public hands. So, and I know all of us and everyone here knows that we can do it because we've done it before. So thank you for having me, and just thank you for everything that you guys have done to make this possible.
And I know on behalf of Assemblymember Rivas, he really wanted to be here today to express his thanks. Unfortunately, he couldn't make it. But to share a little information, this all started during the holidays last year with a number of phone calls. And in one way, it was the worst of times to begin a crisis like this because it was the holidays. But in another way, it was well opportune. It was well timed because it was at the start of a legislative session when work could be done to not only establish the district, but also to do the work necessary to get funding from the state. But also, it was a time when, after 2 years of a long pandemic, people certainly better appreciated what healthcare services mean in our community. What Watsonville Hospital means to people is, when you go through those emergencies, when you have the hundreds of births that take place at Watsonville Community Hospital, you want to know that you can go to your own community, that you don't have to travel far away, that you can, in fact, be there for your loved ones, your friends, your family, in those times of crisis. And so they were truly thankful to be part of this effort, working with an incredible collaboration that are now gonna ensure this is not the final step, this is truly going to be a marathon, but with all you have done in the past year, they have no doubt you'll continue to be a success in running this hospital. So on behalf of Senator Lehr, on behalf of Assemblymember Rivas, thank you for all that you've done to ensure that this Watsonville Community Hospital is truly Watsonville Community Hospital. Thank you.
Carlos Palacios, County Administrative Officer with Santa Cruz County. More than a year ago, a group of these folks up on the screen representing the County of Santa Cruz, City of Watsonville, Salud para la Gente, the Health Trust of the Pajaro Valley, came together with the really one mission, which was to return the Watsonville Community Hospital back to public ownership, which, remember, it was for over 100 years. And the last 20 years were in private ownership. And so that was our one goal. And we really had a 2-year time frame in mind. And then December came, the hospital declared bankruptcy, and suddenly our time frame was much compressed. And so we moved into a crisis mode, frankly, knowing that we had a very short time frame to not only get the healthcare district formed, which was a very big lift, and it's amazing with the help of our legislators that we were able to do. And then on top of that, to come up with a business plan and also the fundraising plan to make this happen. And so I think what part of the key was really getting the entire community to recognize the vital role that the hospital plays, not only in Watsonville and the Pajaro Valley, but in the whole county and even the entire region. I think at first many people thought I would approach people and they thought that's Watsonville's problem, frankly, it's not our problem. But you know what happened over time? Educating themselves, people realized, oh my gosh, this is our whole county's problem. And then people in the region even said, this is a regional goal that we have to get this returned. And so thank you so much for all that you've done to help us, everybody who's here. I want to turn it over to Dori Rosenda, and I know she's going to have a few comments as well, and then we'll thank some of the categories of people that helped as well.
And I just want to echo what Carlos mentioned, I think, early on, where was an incredibly a sort of wave and shared commitment to the importance and the impact that Watsonville Community Hospital has, not just on the patients that it serves, but on the healthcare system as a whole and the region. And through that, and the incredible leadership, of course, from our state representatives and our local county representatives, and across industry, across healthcare, across education and community-based organizations and all of our partnerships, there was the kind of support that results in $65 million and an acquisition of a hospital, formation of a healthcare district, all within 10, how many months was that? 9 months, the time it takes to make a baby. I think that the categories of folks from the representatives, Senator Laird, Assemblymember Rivas, our county board of supervisors from both counties that made commitments and contributions, our healthcare partners, the county staff that leaned in and created all the work that was needed to actually bring the district to life and the district board to be able to function, the district board members who through county board appointment stepped in and dove in headfirst to vertical learning in order to prepare themselves to own and operate a hospital. The hospital administration and leadership the clinician leadership, the staff, who not only went through those 9 months, but on the heels and during the exit of COVID, worked to continue to keep the doors open and to keep, heads high and spirits going forward through bankruptcy. Just an amazing team, and Salud's team, who also leaned in and took on a lot of the work that was involved in transitioning and transferring ownership of the hospital. This is something that has been done in collaboration by individuals from $5 contributions. We've had 500 more than 500 people, entities, contribute from $5 to multi-millions of dollars. And I think it most importantly is for us a moment to say thank you to the project board, the members that are there that have been working with us, and also a commitment and an obligation that this is the beginning. This is the beginning of making sure that Watsonville Community Hospital remains a viable part of this healthcare system and a strong provider of care to the community, and a partner in collaboration with all of you.
So I have a vision, and the vision is that Watsonville Hospital is thriving, is successful, and is one of the most amazing institutions we have in our state. And we're gonna get there. And two of the reasons are our healthcare district people, Marcus Pimentel, Jasmine Ahead are here. I know Stephen Sawyer, CEO of the hospital, is here. I don't know if any of the other board, Katie, I think, was here, Dr. Cox. All those folks who actually stepped up to be on the healthcare district, I want to express my sincere thanks, because that's where they're the ones who are gonna lead the path now. And it's no easy road to be an elected officials nowadays. Anywhere, and it's a tough job that they've taken on. But I'm very confident in them. They're going to do their very utmost to make this vision happen. And I want each of you to be a part of that vision as well. Thank you so much for everything.
Thank you. It's so good to have you here today. And books from your chair. So if you have won a